Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to create, fill, and flatten PDF form fields using the Syncfusion.NET PDF Library. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create, fill, and flatten PDF form fields. Filling a PDF form field involves providing the required data or responses within those fields. Flattening is done to preserve the entered data and ensure that it cannot be modified or changed later. First, I open the existing console application where I have added the Syncfusion PDF library. If you want to know how to get started with the Syncfusion PDF library, please refer to the video link in the card above. Now, I will create a simple form like this in the PDF document using the Syncfusion PDF library. To do this, I need to add the necessary namespace like Syncfusion PDF. Syncfusion PDF Interactive. And Syncfusion PDF Graphics to use the PDF library. Then, I define a method called createForm with void type and add the code to create a form. First, I create an instance of the PDF document. And add a page to the document. Then, define a standard font with name and size to display the text in custom style. Now, I am going to add the title for the PDF document, so I will set the title as Job Application on the PDF page using the drawstring method. Notice here, the Syncfusion drawing namespace is imported automatically when creating .f variable. Next, I will add a text box field to the form, so I will set the label as name on the PDF page using the drawstring method. Then, I create a new text box field using the PDF text box field class. And set its bounds property to specify its location and size on the page. The tooltip property is also set to name field to display a tooltip when hovering over the field. Finally, I add the text box form field to the document. Similarly, I add two more text box fields. Next, I will add a radio button to the form. I will set the label as gender on the PDF page using the drawstring method. Then, create an instance of the PDF Radio Button List field class on the specified page, with the field name gender. I add the Radio Button List field to the document's form fields collection. For this radio button, I am going to display two options, male and female. First, I will set the label male on the PDF page using the drawstring method. And create an instance of the PDF radio button list item class for the male option. and set its bounds property. Similarly, I add one more radio button field for the female option and add button items to the list field. Next, I create an output file stream by saving the output PDF document. And save the document to the stream. I will call the close method to dispose all the memory consumed by PDF DOM as well as disposes its document stream. I will invoke the createForm method to generate a PDF document with form fields. Now, let me save and run the application. Open the output file and see here, a form field is created with a text box and radio button fields. Next, let me proceed to show you how to fill form fields in an existing PDF document. First, I add the necessary namespace, Syncfusion PDF parsing. Then, I define a method called fillFormWithVoidType. And retrieve the PDF file location as a file stream from the specified location. Then create an instance of the PDF loaded document class and initialize it with the FileStream object. Next, get the form from the loaded document using the form property. I get the form field collection from the form using the fields property and cast it to the PDF loaded form field collection object. This object is initialized as null, which will be used to load individual fields to the form. Then, I invoke the tryGetField method to obtain form fields, such as textboxes, checkboxes, etc., and then fill them with the necessary information. If the field is name, it retrieves and sets its text property to Simon's. Similarly, I add email address field and phone field. The gender field is set using the selected index property, where 0 represents the first item on the list, in this case, male. Then, I create an output file stream by saving the output PDF document and save the document to the stream. I will call the close method to dispose all the memory consumed by PDF DOM as well as disposes its document stream. I will call the fill form method to populate values into the form fields in the PDF document. Looking here, a filled PDF document with the defined values for the form fields is displayed. By default, I can edit the values in the form fields in the PDF document. However, if I want to prevent editing, all I need to do is set the flatten property of the loaded form to true. Flattening a form involves converting all the form fields into static content, making the form no longer editable. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to create, fill, and flatten PDF form fields using the Syncfusion PDF library. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our .NET products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.